Now, in this program, any resemblance between the people you see on the screen and real living people is purely intentional. Because, in fact, they are real, and it's our pleasure to catch them in the act of being themselves.
Hey, guys. Rogue Nation here with you today. And we got a banger here, man. This is a regular citizen, and he is finding out what me and everybody that watches this channel realizes is the inefficiency and just downright idiocracy of government, right? So the story we're into here today is the gentleman has two deeded parking spaces in front of his house. And he's met with the city and they've gone over this numerous times. And he's tried to get the police to enforce his deeded parking spaces. He's even had the city print up signs, no parking signs, private parking signs for these parking spaces. And just the way he's treated by the police here, just disgusting. So hopefully this man has got it taken care of. I'm going to call down there and check just to make sure. This is in Jonesboro, Tennessee, by the way. Jonesboro, Tennessee. And the name of the channel is Cretin Build. I'll go ahead and leave a link in the description so you guys can go by and say hi and say thanks for standing up for what's right. You know, having the backbone to actually stand up and not just take it lying down. So, with that being said, guys, we'll get into the video, and as always, we'll have another one for you shortly, because this stuff just does not stop.
The reason I'm showing the video is to show the lengths to which the police department will go to not issue a parking ticket. The first officer was very well controlled, very polite, but continued to simply repeat the same phrase. Private parking spaces, you have to get the vehicle towed. Nothing for us to do. We can't do anything. Have a nice day. I asked him why he was forming that opinion. He told me the chief of police told him to say that. So I, of course, required then for the chief to come and to tell me himself exactly why he was not upholding the law.
You missed it, right? So I'm asking you to issue a parking ticket. If you refuse to issue a parking ticket, I will then be immobilizing the vehicle.
This is private property. If you want to
it is not private property. It is town property. It's Cherokee Street.
If it is blocking your property, you can have it towed. It is a civil
tow matter. Companies are 4 hours from response time.
Okay. So if you want to contact a tow company, but if you
I have contacted
vehicle,
a tow company, I will be immobilizing the vehicle.
Okay.
They can come back to me. They can explain to a judge why they park directly in front of a 2-foot by 3-foot no parking sign. Okay.
So you have been told how to proceed forward?
And you've been told how to proceed forward, too. You've been asked to issue a parking ticket.
I understand what you're asking.
Issue a parking ticket. You are an officer of the police department.
If you have a problem,
you need to issue a parking ticket.
And he'll be there Monday?
No, I'm not waiting until Monday. This guy will be gone. This is the fifth time in the last 3 or 4 days.
I understand you don't like my answer, but that is the proper way to proceed forward, okay?
And the proper way to proceed forward is for the Jonesboro Police Department to enforce the laws in the town of Jonesboro, including issuing park. It is not private property.
So I'm advising you to proceed forward. You don't like my answer. I'm telling you how to proceed forward. If you
and I, if you don't like my answer, right, then you can simply leave. Because I am choosing to have to do it myself, okay. Because the police department is refusing to take the appropriate action. The vehicle.
Okay. You take care, okay?
So right now, the guy that owns this truck is claiming that he lives in our house, and he has the right to park here. And he's claiming that I don't own the parking space.
Where am I?
Are you Mr. Billington?
Yes.
What's going on here, sir?
He just rammed me with his truck.
Okay.
So after the police show up on force, and again are fairly polite, not as nice as the first guy, they simply continue to respond in the same manner. But added to it that since I had parked my vehicle behind this person, blocking him in until the police arrived, I was unlawfully detaining him. I simply told him that I was waiting for the cops to respond, waiting for them to give him a ticket, and was not detaining him. This person, in the meantime, had rammed my vehicle, trying to get out of where I had pinned him in with my truck. I called 911. The police did finally respond. I told them that he had rammed my vehicle twice. I showed them the damage, although it was minor. And in spite of all that and the history behind this, the police chief told me that he would be arresting me for unlawful detainment if I didn't remove my vehicle immediately.
So right now, the guy that owns this truck is claiming that he lives in our house and he has the right to park here. And he's claiming that I don't own the car, the parking space. Where am I?
Are you Mr. Billington?
Yes.
What's going on here, sir?
He just rammed me with his truck.
Okay. And where was he parked?
Where he is currently.
Where are you parked? This is where you were?
This is where I am, calling a tow company as the officer told me to.
Okay.
I'm on the phone calling tow companies, and he rammed me with his truck. Never spoke to me. Never approached me. Never asked me anything. Never asked me to leave. Never spoke to me. Simply stood there with a cigarette hanging out of the window, putting it in drive, putting it in reverse, did it twice, rammed me.
Okay.
Meantime, I'm on the phone with tow companies trying to get someone to tow him.
Did you intentionally put your vehicle behind him?
Absolutely, yes, I did.
Okay, so that is illegal.
Bullshit. These are my parking spaces. These are my parking spaces.
Three times tonight? No, these are
so deal with it.
Spaces.
So the town needs to enforce the parking requirements.
There is no parking requirement. You heard it from the mayor.
Bullshit.
You heard it from the chief of police. You heard it from me.
Absolute nonsense.
This is a civil matter between
absolute
you and the town.
Nonsense. The chief of police and the mayor sat at a table. We talked multiple times. We signed an agreement between the town and us, and the police chief agreed to enforce parking rules. He even delayed the process so that we could get the exact wording of the signage that was compliant with Tennessee state requirements so that he could enforce it. We did that. The town printed the signs. And this is where we are today.
Okay,
you're saying
you,
that you're doing
I'm telling
nothing.
You, listen to me. You parking behind him is dangerously close to false imprisonment.
Bullshit. If you're waiting for the police to deal with the situation.
No, that is not true.
If
you do not give him the ability to leave, your complaint is that he's
I'm waiting for the cops to arrive. I called 911.
Okay, sir. Stand right there.
So this guy is claiming that he owns our house, that these are his parking spaces. The cops are telling me that if I don't move my truck, they're going to arrest me for false imprisonment because I'm not allowing him to move.
So why are parking spaces so important to me? Well, they haven't been ever in my life, except this particular property is downtown Jonesboro. For anyone that knows Jonesboro, it's a highly busy location, very restrictive parking. And this house, this beautiful house, has deeded parking. And that agreement was reached by a former owner that was the descendant of the original owners in return for selling her field to the county for the creation of the parking lot. It was one of the conditions of the sale of that land that she'd be given two spaces in front of the house forever, and it would be reassigned to future owners. The conflict with the town and state started when they refused to honor that deed, that agreement, claimed to have no knowledge of it, could only find in their records an unsigned copy, and hence claimed that it was unlawful, even though they had found it in their records. and refused, which is where this video, of course, starts with me explaining the agreement I eventually struck with the town of Jonesboro.
So they said, wait a minute, and they're going to come back. So we'll see what happens.
So what I'm going to do is...
As far as you're concerned, these are not lawful spaces.
Because you're dangerously close to false imprisonment. You are depriving somebody of their liberties to
leave. I'm waiting for you guys to handle the situation.
So...
By issuing a parking ticket.
I'm not issuing a parking ticket. Nobody's issuing a parking ticket. Because he's not in violation of anything.
No parking.
I spoke with the chief of police.
No parking.
Sir, that is a civil matter between you and the town.
No, it is not.
It is.
That's your opinion, and you're wrong.
Right now,
the mayor and the police chief agreed.
I'm going to explain.
And we have a signed agreement.
I'm going to explain something. You've got a minute to go ahead and move that truck out so this gentleman can move his vehicle. Go ahead and do that.
And you're going to issue the paperwork for the damage.
I am not issuing a citation.
Oh, so you're now not. You said you were going to.
I am going to do a property damage memo.
So go ahead and do it.
I will. He's getting the information. I don't need to do it right now.
I'd like to receive it before I leave.
Yeah, I'll give you the case number. I'm going to do a property damage memo. I'm also going to do an incident.
But I'll see the paperwork that you filled out.
Of you not allowing this man to leave.
I'm waiting to get the appropriate paperwork. If I leave, he hightails it out of here. You then say,
he's free to go. I don't have what I need. As soon as I have his personal information, his license, his plate, I have everything. So for people
that were not here earlier, he claims to own our house, and he has the right to park here.
That is neither here nor there. The here or there is that you pulled a vehicle behind him. You did not allow him to leave. He asked you to leave. I don't know if you were putting a chain on his vehicle or not.
That is a biased, twisted, and political statement.
Did you pull your vehicle behind him?
Yes, I did.
Okay, then you false imprisoned him.
So that he was not here at the time. His vehicle was here
in our private parking spaces.
He has not asked me to move.
So here's the deal, Mr. Billington. You can go ahead and have a seat in your car and move it so he can leave. You already have his information.
Well, I guess I have you on camera saying that you will be doing the paperwork.
I will be.
Right. And I can see something before I leave.
Speak with you. I will give you your case numbers regarding the memo for the property damage and the incident for what we're dealing with here with the parking issue.
Right. But you are refusing to issue a parking ticket.
I am refusing to issue a parking.
And your basis for that is that you don't believe...
This is a civil matter between you and the town.
And you are the town's police department.
I deal with items of a criminal nature. This is a civil nature.
The criminal's not defined by there being a law against
it.
And the town of Jonesboro negotiated with the police department, and we formed an agreement, and we signed it, and the town printed the signs.
Get a lawyer, take the town.
So it's a civil matter. So I'm restraining him on my property.
That is criminal in nature.
Me, really? Somebody enters my property. I ask them, what the hell are they doing there?
He is in a parking space.
There you go. So now it's not civil because it's not mine.
If this is indeed your property, why didn't you follow my first advice and have him towed?
Because I was on the phone to have him towed when he rammed at me.
Why don't you move your vehicle in this other parking spot so he can leave?
And is the chief coming?
He is coming.
Awesome.
You're telling me that the town...
Light out my eyes, please. This is a permitted parking lot for this event.
Including our spaces.
We are not enforcing it. Three of my officers.
You're still not answering my question.
For all of these spaces, it's all permitted.
Right, our private parking spaces that have been agreed by the town.
I'm done discussing it with you at this point. I'm done discussing it. We'll discuss it on Monday. You have three of my officers tied up on a very busy
He rammed me twice with his truck.
Did you do anything to his vehicle?
Absolutely not.
We will discuss it on Monday.
Rammed me twice.
We will discuss it on Monday.
And you guys are ignoring it and doing nothing about it.
We will discuss it on Monday.
Here's your, this is going to be the report number for your property damage.
This one?
Where the vehicle's made contact.
Right.
This is going to be the incident that we've dealt with down here concerning the parking.
Right.
Both reports will be available Monday morning at 8:00.
All right. I will get that, and I'll get a copy of the 911 call as well, I guess, if I request it.
Well, certainly.
Because
certainly.
I'd like. There's a reason that I'm saying it to you guys, right? I called 911.
Over a parking issue? No, absolutely not. What did you call over?
Because I'd been rammed by a vehicle twice.
And that's why I'm here.
That's why he's here.
You responded. When you arrived, you didn't say that's why you responded.
If you called 911 and an officer shows up, what does that tell you?
It There were three requests for officers to come over there the last hour and a half.
First two, I responded to our dispatcher. I said, we are not responding to it. This is a civil matter. You could get the vehicle towed if this is your personal parking spot at your expense. That was one. You called back to the dispatcher.
To say he was ramming me with his vehicle.
No. There was a second call.
Yes, second call. Yes.
You didn't like my answer. And you said that there's personal parking spots put by the chief of police.
You called me.
I verified with the chief of police. And I said, is there any sports?
With this guy.
Yes, the chief of police.
I said, is there any special requirements that he has? These are private parking spots. He explained to me, no, that there wasn't. So I called back. You want to know my answer? Let me finish.
Yes, I do.
I conferred with him to ensure that that was a correct answer that I gave you the first time. He assured me it was.
The fault is not yours.
I gave it back to
fault
the dispatcher.
Fault is not yours. I'm done. I'm okay with what you've told me.
You take it up with him on,
I am okay with what you've told me.
The third call came out is that there was a contact with a vehicle.
Yes.
That somebody had rammed another, that a person was possibly blocking somebody in and putting a chain on a vehicle.
Right. I said I would put a chain on the vehicle.
Did you put a chain on
the vehicle? No, I didn't.
Okay. I came here, you were parked. I said, Mr. Billington, I'm here. What's going on? However that context started, you were upset. This officer was dealing with that.
The point is, the point that I'm trying to make is whether I speak to him, whether I speak to you, whether I speak to the dispatcher, they always make a phone call to somebody and then get back to me and say they're going to do nothing.
Because when you call, sir,
quite frankly, we're in the middle of something just like this, okay?
Right.
The priority is not with you. It's the public safety out here in the middle
of the problem is you won't acknowledge that the town has agreed and licensed these spaces to us.
I don't know what you
And they've informed you of it.
They have not informed me.
Well, Chuck Vest has told me that they have.
They have not informed me of anything.
So I'm glad you're on camera telling me that, because I can play it to Chuck.
Play it to
Chuck. And I can ask Chuck,
we are done.
Why am I being lied to?
Go back to your post.
Lied to by the mayor and lied to by the chief of police.
Okay? If there's an emergency issue you need down here, you call us. If it's a non-emergency and it's
dealing with a parking issue. It's amazing that town officials bold-faced lie.
That's it.
Police chief, bold-faced lies. Amazing. Absolutely amazing.
If you have any other issues that are emergency...
There'll be a complaint about your lying. Yes, there'll be another complaint about your lying.
So, after this incident, the following Monday, I went to see the Director of Public Safety for Jonesboro, and I spoke to the mayor. They both did completely remember the conversation and agreement that we had had. We do, in fact, have a written agreement for these parking spots. And the end result was that I was informed that the police chief would be educated with regard to this issue, and we would not have this problem again.